Hey pharmacist, welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to be doing an unboxing of the Dexcom G7. I'm also going to be setting up the app and applying the sensor to my skin. I've never done this before, I've never set up the app, and the reason I did that is so that we could go through the patient journey together of what they may experience the first time they open their Dexcom G7. Oh, okay. I see what the problem was. So, let's get started. So all that came out of the box was this manual with this, which is an overpatch. I'll get to that. And the sensor inside of the applicator. I think that this here will probably be the most useful for them. And it's a start here guide. And it goes through essentially the basics of what this is, and then it has instructions on setting up the app. And this part here is about inserting the sensor. I'm going to go ahead and open this so we can see what that looks like inside. There is a seal here, so I'm gonna break that seal. It also has a needle inside, which helps with the placement of the filament into the patient's skin. All right, so let's go ahead and apply the Dexcom G7. Now the first thing to decide is where's the sensor going to get placed. So patients have the option of the upper arm for anyone. There's also the option to put the sensor on the abdomen, except for pregnant women. And children who are between the ages of 2 and 6 also have the option to place the sensor on the upper buttocks. But just to reiterate, the back of the upper arm is an option for everyone. Now that the sensor site has been chosen, it's time to prepare the area with an alcohol wipe, so I'm going to do that. Now that that's dry, I'm going to go and insert the Dexcom G7. So take the lid off, and I don't know, am I nervous? I'm not, I know it doesn't hurt. Okay, so let's go ahead. 1, 2, 3. Oh, 1, 2, 3. Oh, okay. I see what the problem was. So here's what I learned. Maybe someone else will experience this too. Ensure that the sensor is really close to the skin and is pushed hard against the skin so that this plastic part here retracts and meets the white part of the applicator. So yeah. The sensor is in, I've got the Dexcom G7, and actually that didn't hurt at all. I didn't really feel it. Maybe I was just also surprised. After you've inserted the sensor into the skin, rub firmly around the patch 3 times. So 1, 2, 3. It's a little tricky. And then gently press on top of the sensor for 10 seconds. Something interesting to note while we wait is that the warm-up period for the Dexcom G7 is 30 minutes and it automatically starts as soon as the sensor is placed. So by the time we get the app set up, hopefully we'll be closer to getting my first reading. The last step is to apply the overpatch. And the overpatch, according to Dexcom, is a must. You must apply this, is what it says on their documentation. So, they say it's probably helpful to use a mirror, but in my case, I'm just going to try without one. Looks like that's pretty decent. And then we'll peel this off. And voila, I'm all set up. The final step in this process is to set up the app. So I'm gonna go to the App Store, search for Dexcom G7. Now it's asking me, am I new to Dexcom or am I an existing Dexcom user? So because I've never done this before, I'm going to create an account. And then it's going to ask about diabetes information, but that's optional. So I'm going to skip. Now my account has been created and this is the screen that I see. And what it does is it walks the patient through 3 steps. The first is an overview of how the G7 works. The second is app setup and connecting it to your phone. And the last is the start sensor. So inserting and pairing the sensor where this code will become very important. So let's go through the first step, the overview. This will go through a lot of the things that we discussed earlier in this video. And it moves through different information that the patient has to either watch or read the text version. And it won't allow you to press next until you've done that. It talks more about the sensor readings, the trend arrows, so on and so forth. So I'm gonna go ahead and continue with this. So now that the overview's done, I'm gonna go ahead and do the app setup. So essentially ensuring that your phone is connected to the device via Bluetooth and that your notifications are on, which is important to get those critical alerts. And then we'll move on to the last step, which is start sensor. So you'll notice on the applicator that there's a pairing code, a four-digit pairing code. You can either insert it manually by putting in the digits, or you can go ahead and take a photo, which essentially scans this QR code here. And once that's done, you'll get a notification that pairing is complete. And there we go. It'll lead to a screen that tells me, in this case, that I have 6 minutes remaining until the warm-up period is done. While we wait for these final minutes, an important counseling tip is that the sensor does need to get replaced every 10 days. Now, there is a very nice feature, which is the 12-hour grace period. That gives your patient the flexibility and convenience to apply a new sensor within the 12 hours after the 10 days is complete. Because the CGM, it's continuously sending glucose readings from the sensor to the app every 5 minutes. So it's unlike the flash glucose system where you have to scan manually. This is sending it automatically. It appears to me that when there's 5 minutes or less, it'll just keep saying 5 minutes and not actually show 4 to 1. So maybe someone might get confused. Oh, okay. Well, I have a low glucose reading. But yeah, nice firsthand experience of what the alerts look like on this app. As I mentioned before, the Dexcom also pairs with the Apple Watch. So I've just gone in here to see what that looks like. And my low reading is also here. And it looks like there's an arrow going down, meaning it's about to get worse, I think. So I'm gonna go eat. Well, I guess that wraps up this video. Thank you so much for joining me on this journey. I hope it gives you a better experience of what your patient may go through the first time they open their G7 and apply it to their skin and download the app. If you found this helpful, please subscribe, give me a like, and I'll see you at the next video. Thanks for watching. Bye, pharmacist.